Hello, MechWarriors! How is it going? Welcome to your daily dose of MechWarrior Online. Today we are playing The Locust! I think this is one of my... Did I play The Locust ever? I don't know, but you wanted to see a super fast, super squishy mech, and I mean, The Locust is one of them. Now we play The Locust 3M here. Why? Because it is able to carry 5 medium lasers, and I think 5 medium lasers are pretty, pretty decent on The Locust. So I wanna play hit and run here. I wanna be able to peek at mid-range. I wanna be able to deal some damage and then get out of the fight again, and then engage from another angle and then shoot again. The Locust has, again, an overwhelming speed here, so 54 kph almost. That's a lot of fun, so use that mobility. You don't have any armor, but being able to shoot at mid-range is, I think, a little bit more beginner friendly than using the small pulse laser loadout in the other Locusts, and therefore I'm trying this today. The skill build is non-existent, actually. I have 7 skill points unlocked because, as you might tell, I'm not playing that many light mechs. But yeah, I was going for rated deprivation first, and I'm like, this Locust gets a lot out of artillery and airstrikes. So I was working down my way towards the airstrikes because you can get into crazy flanking positions just dropping artillery and airstrikes on the heads of your unaware opponents and then just get out again. So therefore, going for this first is probably a good idea, and then afterwards definitely radar deprivation because you want to be able to break line of sight and then instant lock. So that's very important. After that, you're free to go. Probably maxing firepower, getting a lower cooldown, lower laser duration, so that you don't have to expose yourself so much. And then probably mobility, just maxing out speed, and maybe operations to keep the DPS up, because the build will run hot, because you are actually able to fire all the time when your team is in a team fight, in a brawl. And then you can just run around and say, hey, you get a shot, and you get a shot, everybody gets a shot. So that's a thing. So you will run hot at some point if you do something like this, and therefore probably again going for classic laser vomit, going down the left arm here, just mirror it on the right arm, something like this here, and then the same for the right side, then speed tweak, and then operations full for maximum cooling. But yeah, that's the build so far. I wish you all a lot of fun in the 2 games that are coming. And if you have that, then don't forget to leave a rating or subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. And now it's time to hit the battlefield. Alright, first game of the day. We are playing the Forest Colony. We are playing Skirmish. I expect the enemy to come from Hotel 8. And therefore, I am going to set up here. And I want to scout a little bit. At the moment, in the first phase of the game, I cannot do anything else. So let's try to get some intel on the enemy's movement and their mechs. And Piranha Hotel 7. Okay, this is not that close. But still. Let's see what we can do here. So we have 5 medium lasers, which is actually respectable in terms of damage. But, of course, the best scenario we can get, of course, is that the enemies are bound in a fight with my main force here. And we can... Oh, there's a guy. We can just run around like crazy. Come on. Spot it. We can run around like crazy and just shoot them. I think I've been spotted, maybe. Maybe not. Okay, we got some damage out here. I might have been spotted. Oh, we gotta get super close here. Try to get up there. I cannot. I think I need more speed to do that. It is possible, probably. But I wanna see if the Uziel is coming here. Doesn't seem like it. So maybe we get another shot out. Okay, no, never mind. I know, I'm not in optimal range there. But every point of damage is good. So being more or less behind the enemy lines here. Target acquired. Okay, 600 meters. Target acquired. Target spotted. Cannot hit anything right now. I think I've been spotted by now. So let's reposition. I do not want to be here anymore. I mean, I am trying to spot the enemies acquired. And if they get locks on me, or at least see the blip on the minimap, then, you know, they know that I'm here acquired. And I'm up for no good. It's a Cougar SRM's Ultra AC-10. Almost core, though. Wait, this is a guy. Yeah, there was a guy with ECM. Okay, let's get out of here. Ooh, yeah, this could be horrible for me. Full enemy firing line there. Let's pop up here real quick. Ugh, just some damage out. At the moment, I'm just annoying them a little bit. Not dealing serious damage. And, you know, I'm just playing the harasser role. Ooh, wait, there's a rifleman. Let's go for heat vision. He's just right below me. Bring up my UAV here. I want to see if there's something around. If I pop out... It's looking good, actually. Hey, King Crab. Trying to go for the center there. Oh, actually, the side torso. The side torso is damaged already. They're not aware. Hopefully. Oh, now they are. Okay. But we got this. Ah, crap. No, 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 no. Let's get out of here. Uziel is critical as well, which is good. So, if he's still there... I got a kill on something. Alright. We could probably hunt down the Uziel. Probably. I don't know what's up here. Awesome. PPCs. Could be devastating if that PPC hit my leg there. So, let's try to move. Let's try to squirrel around a little bit. Let's be active. Stopping, pushing, stopping, pushing. This is what we do here. And I dive down to cover now. Okay, the awesome is probably gonna be my priority here. It should be. Honestly, it should be. Well, let's chain fire to manage the heat. Okay, we got this. And... yeah, he's down. Okay, I'm gonna leave him. I'm not taking the kill, because I want to cool down here. We want to use our heat on more interesting targets, which is, for example, this Banshee there. Hit and run, hit and run. Never stop moving. And if you are in one position, if you want to stay in one position, just push your mag back and forth so that it's harder for the enemy to hit it. Side torso open. Side torso down. Oh no, center torso down. Nice one. Okay, here we go. This is a little bit riskier now. There's a commando coming in, and if he's trying... what? I am in the thing? How am I in the thing? Can I get out of the thing? Look at this! Hello? I have no idea how I ended up here. I can get out. Okay. Okay, in the meantime, my team is destroying everybody. Nice step here. Alright. Oh, airstrike. Ooh, dodge it like a boss, though. Hi, Commando. Commando is gonna be tough. Tough to kill. Maybe. Try to hit his center torso there. Let's go for heat vision, that's easier. Oh, he's actually running stealth. Dude, I can still see you. Wait, where is he? Got him. Alright, nice. Okay, assassin, super crit. One shot, actually. Let's try to intercept him. Nice. 11, and the last one is an urban mech. Cool. Nice game here. I like that. Was very nice dynamic, and actually, as you can see, I could, at some point, I could just maneuver completely freely around the mechs while my team was keeping them busy, and we could just focus on damaged components and everything, so that was really cool. We even got two killing blows. Nice game. We got, two kills, 8 assists, we got 308 damage out here, we got two components destroyed. That's the first round. Let's go over to the next one and see how this will go down. Alright, second game of the day. We are playing the Canyon Network and we are scouting. So let's go ahead and try to get some shots on the Osiris there. Oh, maybe this guy. Alright, it's an Uziel in 500 meters. Nice. So I want to be behind the enemy's lines because we have some Wolfpack going on. Wolfpack being a lot of light mechs trying to group up and hunt down a single target. For example, the Osiris. Okay, oh, maybe. I'm on the Archer. Let's see. Also, there's a Piranha. Let's drop artillery on the Archer. Ow, stop that. He didn't get my artillery out. Okay, never mind. New target acquired. Ah, and I didn't get the shots to the Piranha properly. All right, took damage for nothing. Not nothing. I mean, we keep them in place here, and this is really good. I should probably focus more on the Archer than on the Piranha, and do some more hit and run shenanigans here, and better ones actually. So, the thing that we did before was not really working out. Wow. We completely pulled them off here. Pulled them away from their team. This is working out perfectly for us. Like, we created so much space for our main force to approach. This is great. I love it. The light mech skirmishes here. Again, although I lost a good amount of my armor already. Which is not that much in general. And one of our light mechies is down. Okay. So what we do? We kill this guy. Right. We shouldn't really try to engage the Piranha directly.
That's Charlie 4.
But if we can do something like this, it would be fine. Okay, let's see where he's going. Making the target target spotted thing, a habit is actually a great thing. Try to internalize that. Oh, here's the piranha. This is exactly what I didn't want. Again, fighting him directly.
Oh, and two LRM assaults and Charlie 4.
Okay, did we get him? No, only the arm. And he is actually pretty scared here because we have three Malite Mechs and we could definitely ruin his day. Is he?
New target acquired.
Is there an Uziel there? Let's go for the center. Or for this guy, actually. Okay. Yeah, let's focus on the piranha. Damn it. Drop down here. But he is lagged. Nice. Cool. Now, speaking of cool, the Uziel needs to get killed as well. And now we're gonna regroup. Ah, this wolf pack is working out perfectly. What's that? Cougar. Yeah, let's kill the Cougar. Seriously, he's running ATMs, but he's super cored. Let's try to get a good shot on his center. Maybe that works. Maybe not, because he's dead already. Ah, nice opportunity here. I couldn't get it. And now it's time for artillery. Oh no, maybe not. Because it's used already. Okay. Oh, missiles. Okay, we're gonna dive down here. Whoop. Break line of sight, break locks, wait for the artillery to be ready. And then we're gonna go out. Drop it on this guy. And we're gonna turn around and run. Because there's a King Crab with big guns coming over. Okay. We are up here now. Nice. On top of the King Crab. Hey, dude.
Target spotted.
Nope, not enough. Our team is actually dying, which is not so good. What about the King Crab? King Crab's side also is open. I think King Crab's side also is down? Not quite. I hit the arm. Okay, he's not focusing me, so it seems. No, we can just stay here. Yeah, he's focusing somebody completely different. And we are fine. Cool. The urban mech, I love it. Whenever there's a kill, he's like, woo woo, sirens, woo woo. So good. So let's use some time to dissipate some heat here. Is that the commander from before? Yeah, most likely. Okay. Problem is the heat, of course. But he's down to one SRM2. Let's go in, get something done here. Just stay in motion. What is he running? He is cored in the first place. Okay. Nice kill there. Nice follow-up. And that's the commando. Oh, this is so fun to play. So I think I got it now. I think I know how to play this Locust now. Like, being active all the time here really helped. Hey, dude. I'm gonna go for the center. Not the commando. Not the commando. This guy. Hi. Gauss rifle. Could have been my death. But I believe he's shooting so much to other people. Come over here, dude. I wanna get you. No, wasn't enough. Nice one. Cool game. I like this light mech dynamics here. Like, we were constantly in motion, trying to find an angle on the enemy, and that was a lot of fun. Nice job, Alpha Lance. That was a lot of fun playing with you here, guys. Now, what did we do? We got one killing blow. We got 8 assists. We got actually one kill mouse damage dealt. 461 damage with 4 components destroyed. That was the Locust, everybody. That was the Speed Freak. I hope you enjoyed the video. And if you did, then don't forget to leave a rating or subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. And if you want to support the channel and help me out doing what I'm doing here, then go down below to the description. There is the link to my Patreon page. And I hope to see you on the battlefield. Goodbye.